it's essentially like a smart barbecue grill. Temperatures at the top end will reach 1800 to 2000 degrees Fahrenheit, designed so that we can mimic wildfire type of conditions. We can sequence various rows of burners and allow the flames to progress in a certain fashion. This is the flame front simulator. It allows us to create and simulate a moving fire front to test different types of equipment and look at the heat exposure on those types of equipment. We are looking at improving the experience of firefighters to benefit personnel in the field and equipment that they interact with across the nation. The simulator, it allows us to test in a more repeatable way with much more controlled variables.
And it's allowing fuel to flow through. You can just barely hear it. Here's it up.
In the past, when we needed tests, we would actually light a real fire. And once you start the fire, you can't just turn it off. In our system here, it allows us to be able to start and stop the feed of propane so that we can stop the burn. It allows us to do far more amounts of tests than we would be able to do otherwise. And for this particular data set, we're looking for what the temperatures are inside the fire shelters and see the fire behavior around the fire shelter is at that point. A full holistic story around what's happening inside the shelter. This data will allow us to create a procedure and a process more uniform in our testing for the development of future equipment. The National Technology and Development Program has tested a lot of equipment, and that includes things like fire engines, pumps, personal protective equipment, and ignition devices. In the National Technology and Development Program, it's an easy straight line between what we do and the benefits to make fire operations more efficient, make firefighters safer, and in effect, also do better for the public. The challenges that we face and that we tackle are really important, and the ways that we can solve for those challenges really move the agency forward.